Hi, everybody. Now I am in Chorrillos Pier. Behind me there is a sea, and there is a kind of exhibition of food and clothes and so on. So the idea, I am with my bicycle. The idea is to go from Chorrillos to Miraflores, which is about 6 kilometers one way, and I will try to record all the way along from here to Chorrillos until the Miraflores neighborhood. That's the idea. The meanwhile, perhaps I will stop from time to time in order to have some views of the place. Okay?
So we are going through this exhibition. There are some books around, and not only that, but ornaments and some games, bijouterie, and so on. So let's go ahead. We are going through the beach. This is a pier. It is not so overcrowded. There are just some people around. And let's see how it goes. It's about 16 hours in the afternoon. Today is Friday, the 3rd, November the 3rd. I'm gonna stop here.
Okay, this is a general view from the Chorrillos Pier of the Lima Bay here in Lima, Peru. Okay, the exhibition is behind me. I am already in the Chorrillos Pier. There are some buildings behind me, and you will see the Pacific Ocean on the other side of the pier. So let's go on cycling and come along with me in order to see the little trip.
Okay, we are already by the beach. I'm gonna make some pictures. Knowing how people drive is still a little bit dangerous, like cycling in Lima. So you have to be aware in order to avoid some bad situations. Okay. There are some new buildings around. There are some new buildings around in Lima. Department buildings. Lima is growing to the sky. Just because there was a kind of growing of the building industry, the construction industry, and called building boom or something like that. I don't know exactly how it is the translation, but it is changing the landscape of the city. It's not the same. Okay, we are almost in the border that divides Chorrillos from Miraflores district. Both are southern neighborhoods here in Lima. Perhaps Barranco is one of the most touristic places where people usually come and hang around, and it's pretty nice. Okay.
Hi again. I am almost by the sea. I am at the beach, recording this part of the little trip cycling from Chorrillos to Miraflores district. And as you can see, there are some people lying on the sand. It's about 16:30 in the afternoon, and there are some brown cliffs behind me and the buildings. There are some buildings around. So, let's continue. Thank you.
Okay, this is Kala. Kala restaurant, which is one of the most exclusive and well-known restaurants in Peru. And it is expensive just because it is by the sea. So you have a beautiful view of the Pacific Ocean. And it's pretty nice just because the sunset is very beautiful. Perhaps we will reach part of the sunset. Okay, now I am in the border, in the boundary of Barranco, Barranco neighborhood or Barranco district, and we are in Miraflores. Okay, perhaps Miraflores is one of the most touristic places in Peru. Because it is supposed to be safety, and there are a lot of places to go sightseeing, and it makes it a nice place to enjoy. Overall, if you are from abroad, and you can have views like this one. Okay, I will stop for a while. Let's see where. Maybe I will go straight ahead and let's rest a little bit forward. What's that? What are they doing? I don't know. Okay, we are close to this restaurant called Nautic Rose. That would be the proper translation. Okay. This is where people usually surf. And surprisingly, there are a lot of people from other parts of the world that enjoy the Peruvian waves. And although I am not a surfer, I know that Peruvian waves are one of the best in the world. What's up? Okay, we are going straight ahead. I will try to get an strategic point. I mean, we will try to reach a bridge from where we are going up and then go back to my neighborhood, my place. Okay, more people are surfing over there. It's pretty cool. I wish I could surf as them, but I have to learn a lot. I don't know if I could do it just because I am a little bit older. Old. Okay, we keep cycling, then we have to go up. And that part is going to be a little bit hard. I will tell you why. There are some workers. It seems as if we had a sort of event. Okay. Okay, this place is pretty nice. And this is the end of my little trip.
Okay, so we reached this part of the trip of the way. And the beach is behind me, and as you can see, people is surfing. They are really enjoying this beautiful day because the sun is shining and summer is just around the corner, as well as the Christmas time, the Christmas season. And Christmas means many things for me because it makes me think about my days when I was at school and my studies, my school year was about to finish, and I was very worried about the, you know, qualifications, you know. So what we have to do is to go up and then go back home. So come along with me.
Okay, we are going back. And we have to go there. And it's going to be a little bit hard, but let's see how can we deal with it. Lots of people come together in order to get good pics. It is a sort of championship, surfing championship. I'm not sure. Okay. And this is the part which is going to be a little bit hard. And what makes it harder is the fact that my bicycle is a little bit well, it's not light, it's heavy.
Well, obviously, I am not in the best of my shape. But yeah, I'm a little bit tired, and I was going up from that bridge until this point, carrying the bicycle on my own. And this bicycle is a little bit heavy, and that's the problem. But well, we will have to deal with that. Okay, already reached the top of this place. The pier is just about some meters up, but I will take a rest just for a while. I'm a little bit tired. As I mentioned before, the bicycle is a little bit heavy, but it's okay. It's a very nice view from here. The golden hour is just about some minutes. Well, we are almost in the golden hour. Okay, I will record this part of the trail, which is a kind of workout for me, because it's been some months since the last time I came here with my friend Alejandro, who is not already living in my neighborhood. And we used to do this way, but I don't know if he is still cycling. You just enjoy the panorama. Thank you.
This is Miraflores. This is the Navy Lighthouse. We are going through this way for you to enjoy the view. Okay. Ah. after cycling around here, now we are going back to the south of Lima. Okay. I really enjoy cycling around here. It is an enjoyable panorama. Okay, we are now in Larcomar, which is a commercial center. This is the heart of Miraflores, the downtown of the most visited district in Peru. I don't know if I will take, let me see where I should go. Okay, I think we are going straight ahead. Ooh. The amount of cars in the streets are growing because of the this time of the day. And so we have to get to Barranco and we will try to we are trying to avoid the traffic. Okay. A lot of cars. Okay, we are already in Barranco. This is also a beautiful place. And now, look at this beautiful sunset here in Lima. This is a sort of bohemian neighborhood, a place where a lot of writers, poets, and artists decided to come together to live in, just because, as you can see, the architecture is so beautiful. Nowadays, it's a place to visit if you want to enjoy a great time. Beautiful restaurants, nice pubs and bars. It offers a romantic environment. When I had girlfriend, we usually come here. Okay, I will take this way. Look at the houses. They are very classic and aesthetic. Okay, this street, which is covered by century trees, it was a very quiet place, and as you can see, I am riding the bike over the tramway. The tramways, I don't know exactly the name of English, but you know, the support that make the tramways to work. We are close home. Look at the houses. And we are getting to the last part of this short trip. And now we are in Chorrillos, my neighborhood. Which is totally different compared to the architecture of the places we were recently. Those electric motos are in fashion in Lima due to the pandemic situation. Okay, this is the end of this little trip. I hope you have enjoyed this.
Okay, this is the end of our travel. The sunset is behind me, as you can see. It's very beautiful. This is Chorrillos.